This is my love song to you. Let every woman know I'm yours, so you can fall asleep each night, babe, and know I'm dreaming of you more. You're always hoping that we make it. You always want to keep my gaze, but you're the only one I see, love. And that's the one thing that won't change. I will never stop trying. I will never stop watching as you leave. I will never stop losing my breath every time I see you looking back at me. And I will never stop holding your hand. I will never stop opening your door. I will never stop choosing you, babe. I will never get used to you. And with this love song to you, it's not a momentary phase. You are my life, I don't deserve you, but you love me just the same. And as the mirror says we're older, I wanna look the other way.
You guys love very well. You know, sometimes as individuals, as people, we have a hard time loving other people or doing things that are not comfortable for us. And you guys always go out of your way to make other people feel comfortable and to love other people. And we thank you so much for that. We know that that's just something that God has put in your heart, that to love people when people might not feel loved, or they might feel like no one's for them, or no one reaches out to them, and you guys come along and you pick them up and you do things for them that maybe no one else has ever done. But that third party in that covenant is what truly gets you through. It's what helps you love the other individual sometimes when you might not feel it.
Today I become your husband and you become my wife. I will strive to give you the best of myself while accepting you the way you are. I promise to respect you as a whole person with your own interests, desires, needs, and realize that those are sometimes different, but no less important than my own. And lastly, I promise to watch over you to the best of my abilities.
Jesus, about 2 years ago, I started praying for my future husband and asked God to deliver me a man who loves Jesus and will love me like Christ loves the church. And there is not a shadow of a doubt in my mind that you are that man. When I met you, thanks to our dogs, I never would have imagined we would be standing here today, but God was and is at work in our hearts and our lives. He has blessed me with a husband who fiercely protects me and cares for me in the most gentle and humble of ways. Being able to witness your kindness to others and your desire to give sacrificially to those around you has truly encouraged my heart and soul so much. I'm so excited for my future with you and cannot wait to start a family of our own, because I know you'll be as great of a father as you are a husband. We will face many struggles along the way, and I am confident that with God's grace, we'll persevere through every trial and celebrate all the joyous moments that He blesses us with. I promise to encourage you, support you, and submit to your leadership. I will choose to love you every single day, and I cannot wait to become with my dads and my best friend.
I give you this ring. As a reminder.
That I will live.
Honor and cherish you. In all times.
In all places.
And in all ways.
Forever.
You put the ring on. I give you this ring. As a reminder.
That I will live.
Honor.
And cherish you.
In all times. In all places. And in all ways. Forever. Mark 10:6. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they're no longer two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let not man separate. with this union of hearts and hands, and by the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel, and by the laws of the state of Arizona, and in the name of the Almighty God, our Father, it is my honor as a friend to pronounce you man and wife. Drum roll. Jesus, you may kiss your bride. It is my honor to announce to you Mr. and Mrs. Jesus and Sarah Lopez.
The sun fade out to a dark sky. Can't say I'd even notice it was absent.
Such a rare quality, and one that I think will help him out with many aspects of his life, including marriage.
That there came a point where I would throw fits when they would try and take you away from me. I would cry and say, my baby, lucky for us, I eventually learned to love you. In fact, I loved you so much I didn't want mom or dad to take you away.
Oh, don't you dare.